government lab called NREL, or National Renewable Energy Lab. It is a very good resource which plots out all these maps, solar spectrum, and all kind of other resources for renewable energy, and renews them every year as well. And what it shows here is solar energy in the United States. And if you look at the Bay Area over here, it's like this color yellow. So it corresponds to roughly 5.3 kilowatt hour per meter square per day. And if you translate into divided by 24, that's roughly 208 watt per meter square. So this is the average number for Bay Area over the period of 1 year. During the peak, that is, you know, during summer and during daytime, this number is 1,000 watts per meter square. And of course, during night, this number is 0 watt per meter square. So it varies from 0 to 1,000 watt per meter square in the Bay Area. And on an average, it's 208 kilowatt per meter square. And it varies from month to month as well. So, you know, this is the map for January, and this is the map for July. So it varies quite a lot from, you know, summer to winter, but on an average you get 5 kilowatt hour per meter square in the Bay Area. Right, so now that I know how much energy I get, the question I ask myself is, you know, do I install solar panel on my home or not? And that's the question, you know, you should all ask yourself, depending upon where you live, what amount of energy you get, you know, and you can assume some particular efficiency of solar power conversion. So over here, I've taken a very conservative number. I've assumed an efficiency of 10%, right? So resource is 5 kilowatt per meter square per day. Efficiency is 10%. Then I talked to you know that on sometime it peaks up to 1,000 watt per meter square. So during peak hours, I can produce up to 100 watt per meter square. And on an average, if I want to like generate 1 terawatt of power, I need this much area of 220 kilometers square. So there's a paper which I've uploaded on the class website which talks about to meet the entire energy need of US, you need like the space equivalent of a Mojave Desert to generate the whole energy requirement of the US. But on more realistically, from my perspective, from a person who's trying to install a solar panel on his house, so over a period of 20 years, let's assume, you know, my solar panel will last for 20 years. So from 1 meter square area, so I get 5 kilowatt hour per meter square. Then I have taken a very conservative efficiency of 10% for converting into electricity. And then I multiply it into 365 days a year into 20 years. Over 1 meter square, I'll generate this much power, 3650 kilowatt hour, right? So now, I also pointed out in my utility bill that I pay 10 cents per kilowatt hour. So now, essentially, over 20 years, I'm generating $365 worth of electricity, or $365 worth of power per meter square of area. And we also pointed out that, you know, on a peak, on when it's like the solar energy is at its maximum, you generate 100 watt per meter square. So on a peak, I generate like $3.77 worth of power given a peak solar intensity. So now the big question comes, how do I finance this, right? So I have to figure out, now I know how much worth of energy I generate over 20 years. So the only question I need to figure out is how much do I pay for it upfront, right? So $365 worth of electricity is generated per meter square over 20 years, but it's generated over 20 years. And when I'm installing solar panel at my house, I'm paying for it upfront, right? So I won't obviously pay $365, and I mean, if somebody comes to you and say, you know, let me borrow $365 and I'll pay it over 20 years without interest, obviously you won't, you know, that's not a deal you'll take, right? So I need to take into account what is the interest rate. So instead of putting this $365 into solar panel, if I put in a bank, how much would I, or if I invest this money, how much return can I get? And I take a number of 6% over here, and this number depends a lot from country to country. Interest rates in US are much lower. If you were installing the same panel in India, your interest rate would be much higher. It would be 8% or so, right? And it depends upon your size of your company or your organization. If I'm borrowing money from bank to installing the solar panel, I'll be paying a much higher interest rate rather than a company which is a, you know, multi-billion dollar company, and they, when they withdraw a loan, they pay barely an interest rate of 1 or 2%. So this is a very highly variable number. This number is fixed, that, you know, we have 20 years to extract this power from it. And then I'm taking a very conservative number that I won't require any maintenance over the period of 20 years. So if I take that number and just put it into this equation, what I determine is that I can pay $209 for this $365 upfront if my interest rate is 6% and it's a loan or it's a lease for 20 years. So that gives me the number that, you know, the number that I can afford is roughly $2.10 per watt peak power. And as of today, you know, the install cost is roughly $4 or $5 per watt. And I've assumed, I've taken a number of, and this includes the installation cost and everything. That's like $3, which is installation cost. Around $2 is the cost of your module. And if I take the efficiency of 20% over here, this number will, you know, increase to 4.2, and, you know, it will start to make more sense. So I've taken this, I've done this analysis with a very conservative efficiency, but there's a homework problem where you'll do it with more realistic efficiency. So the next question I ask myself is, do I do it now? Or, you know, I've heard these things that the price of solar cells falls every year, so why not wait a few years and do it a few years later, right? So this is true of all technological, pretty much true of all high-tech industries, that you can fit the price versus the capacity or versus year in this exponential function. And you can relate it to, you know, there are these parameters which is called as experience parameter. So it essentially relates that, you know, if your price is say $1 this year, how much is the price next year? And it depends upon how much is the production this year versus how much is the production last year. And this exponential is different for different technologies. For something like wind turbine, which is a very mature technology, this exponential is very small. For something like solar, this exponential is roughly 0.3. And there's another number which people define, which is this progress ratio, which is 2 to the power of minus this experience parameter. And that's roughly, if you put that exponential here, it comes out to be 82%. So what it means is that, you know, the price of my solar panel, it falls, it has that progress ratio of 82%, or it falls by roughly 20% every year. And you can derive the same thing for Moore's law. So Moore's law, the price falls by half, or at least used to fall by half every 2 years. So progress ratio for Moore's law would be 50%, and that would be even sharper curve, right? So assuming this progress ratio, and this is plotting, you know, the price, if I keep on following this progress ratio, and I can take conservative estimates on my progress ratio, I can assume it, it's either 80% or 78%. So it will keep on falling, and it says, you know, within currently our installed capacity for solar is around 65 gigawatt per year. So when it reaches like, you know, 300 gigawatt per year, this should fall less than 50 cents per watt, and maybe, you know, I should wait a few years and then buy it, not buy it now. And this is the, so that was, you know, more data in the early 2000s. This is real data from last few years. So you can see it has been approximately following that progress ratio of fall in price of 20% per year, and more. That was, you know, a lot of it was incentivized by, this progress was incentivized by the US government. Then there was a change where, you know, there was a transitional change in the region from production went from US to China, and then you see a sudden drop. Right now you can buy a solar module for 80 cents a watt. And in 2015 or so, when your production capacity, the Sunshot program's targets, it has this target of 50 cents per watt. So maybe when the installed capacity reaches, like, you know, instead of 65 gigawatt per year, it reaches like close to 800 or 700 gigawatts per year, I should be able to buy it at this price. And that's what, you know, this DOE funds a lot of research, which is under, how many of you are, is anybody here funded by this? Apparently they fund a lot of people in Stanford, but they, so that's their target. And maybe I should wait 5 years, you know, why, what's the hurry? And there's another projection that says that this is the price of utility. So currently I'm paying 10 cents per watt, and it's, people assume that this will go up. I'm not sure if this would necessarily be the case, but and the price of solar should come down, and roughly around 2016, for sure, without any subsidies, you should have grid parity. And so, I mean, for a person who wants to, you know, start a career in this field, or, you know, enter this field now, even though it's very gloomy right now in the US, it might still make a lot of sense, because when that grid parity hits, you know, there'll be much more opportunities in that field. So a good time to invest or a good time to enter that field would be still now, even though it doesn't look that rosy, right? So a final question before we go into more technical things is that, how many panels do I need? So I figured out, you know, all that economics, but how many do I actually need? So I'm consuming 446 kilowatt hour in 31 days. So, you know, this bill was drawn every 31 days. So I'm consuming on an average, this divided by 31, that's around 14.3 kilowatt per hour day. And apparently that's larger than the US average, so I need to cut down on my energy consumption, but the US average is 10 kilowatt hour per day. So anyway, so if I assume again that I assume now that my I can buy modules of 20% efficiency, how much area do I need? So I have this 10 kilowatt hour per day need. On an average, I get 200 watt per meter square. Efficiency is 20%. Put those number in, I get an area of 10 meters square. And we just figure out that I could pay up to $200 per meter square. So if I pay around $2,000, I should be able to, you know, meet my energy needs. Or in my case, I have to pay, since I'm consuming more, $3,000 upfront payment versus paying $40 per month, on and on and on. So, you know, I in one of the homeworks probably you will do this energy analysis for yourself. But the point I want to emphasize is it's not that far off. It's like, you know, we have to reduce it by 50%, but we should be able to do it in the next 5-6 years or so.